Welcome back guys. Hari ini saya nak ajar balancing equation, balance chemical equations. Ramai student ada masalah untuk balancing chemical equation. So stay tuned with me. Saya akan ajar the basic balance chemical equations until to a bit complicated one. Okay, let's look. Kalau dia bagi satu balance, simple equations like this. Na plus with the HNO3. A basic principle that you should know untuk this kind of equation adalah kita kena tahu pecahkan dia according to the cation and anion. Seperti, let's say, we know the cation A adalah charge dia adalah Na plus. That's a very general rule. This is based on the cation and anion. Dan juga yang ni, HNO3 ni, dia boleh pecah jadi H plus dan NO3 minus. Therefore, a basic principle that we should know adalah cation will be combined with the anion to form an ionic compound lah. This is a very common method of things. Di mana guys, as we know, the Na must be attracted to the NaO3. So as you can see over here, Na plus with the NO3 minus. Yang kita tahu adalah Na ada nombor 1, ini ada nombor 1. Therefore, kita crosskan dia, want to make a chemical bonding, this and this. Then, we will get NaNO3. Since yang ni dengan ni dah mati, only this left behind. In chemistry, you must remember 7 gases, 7 ions. There are 7 ions which is kita ada H plus, kita ada O2 minus, kita ada N3 minus, F minus, Cl minus, Br minus, and I minus. In any chemical reactions, you are doing any chemical equation like this, remember, kalau kamu come across those 7 ions in an equation and dia tak ada pair, without any pairing, then it going to combine with itself to form a molecule. What I'm trying to say, the H plus going to combine with itself and form a H2. And this one will form a O2, and definitely the rest is still the same lah. Ini dari ni, ni dari ni, Cl -2 and Br2 and I2. Ini semua adalah akan dipanggil sebagai diatomic gases. Remember, diatomic gases in any chemical equation only will take place when dia dah tak ada calon lain. Maksudnya, it's alone in this equation. There is no pair for this hydrogen ion. Therefore, it will combine with itself untuk membentuk a molecule of H2. Guys, remember, in any balancing equation, do not too excited. Kita kena tengok, is this balanced or not? By looking at the equation, you know, this is 1 and this is 1. It is look like balance on left-hand side and right-hand side. Dia memang nampak balance. Tapi, kalau kita tengok, H2, if you are looking at this H2, over here we have 2, and here we only have 1 H. Therefore, this is not balanced. How to balance this adalah by putting, this is 2, am I right? And this is 1. And we put a 2. Remember, the big number is, kita letak ke depan ni, adalah untuk multiply to each element inside. Maksudnya, nombor ni, it multiply to all. Nombor ni boleh didarab untuk setiap unsur yang ada di dalam. Sekarang ni, we already know how many nitrogen hydrogen we have. 2. How many NO3 that I have? NO3 ni kita anggap dia sebagai satu pasang. NO3. Therefore, kat sini ada 2. Kat sini, I only have 1. Therefore, I will multiply this with 2. Guys, remember, sekarang problemnya, the problem is, now how many sodium do I have? Natrium kat sini ada 2. And the natrium over here is only 1. So, simply multiply by putting a 2. So, by looking again the equation, 2Na, 2Na, 2H, and 2H, and 2NO3, and 2NO3. Therefore, this is a balanced chemical equation. Stay tuned for more videos on balancing chemical equations.